This provocative claim by the late great anthropologist David Graeber has proved very influential, both amongst academics and the public. But is there actually any truth to it? This is what Magdalena Sofia, Brendan Birchall, and myself investigate using a European survey of 30,000 workers. According to Graeber, the number of employees doing useless jobs is not only high, around 50% of all paid work, but it's been increasing rapidly in recent years, especially in occupations connected to finance, marketing, and administration, and among young workers with student debt. And perhaps most importantly, Graeber outlines the spiritual violence of doing useless jobs and how this is highly damaging to mental health. In a new article, we find that Graeber was right to highlight the negative effect of useless jobs on mental health, but his theory was wrong in all other regards. Only around 5% of workers feel their job is useless, and that number has been declining. Additionally, those in low-end jobs, such as cleaners, are more likely to feel their job is useless than young workers in finance, the opposite of what Graeber's theory predicts. In fact, the feeling that your job is useless is actually associated with experiences of toxic management rather than being a true reflection on the social value of one's job. We think then that useless jobs are better understood in terms of the social relations at work and how these can leave workers feeling alienated from their human capacities. We should be grateful to Graeber for raising awareness of the harms of useless work. But rather than thinking of this as bullshit jobs, we need to overturn the social relations that leave people's work devalued by the toxic workplace management.